Good morning, children. Welcome to your science class. Okay, we have already finished our lesson, Air, Wind and Cyclone. Now I'll discuss the question answers. Okay, here you see ma, we are having first fill the blanks. I told you to do homework. Few of you are having doubts. Now I will read and tell the question answers. First one, take page textbook number 79. Also take your workbook page number 107. First take your textbook page number 79. Take your textbook, everybody. See, fill the missing words in the blank spaces in the following statements. First one, wind is dash air. Wind is dash air. Wind is moving air. When the air is moving, it is called wind. B, winds are generated due to dash heating on the earth. Winds are generated due to dash heating on the earth. Due to uneven heating. Due to uneven heating. Near the earth's surface, dash air rises up. Various dash air comes. Which air will move? Hot air or warm air. Okay, and which air will come down? Cool air. Next, D. Air moves from a region of dash pressure to a region of dash pressure. High to low. Air moves from high pressure to low pressure. Next, second one, suggests two methods to find out wind direction at a given place. These I will show you how to do. This is an activity where we will make one experiment. I will show you in the video. Next class, okay, prepare with carbon sheet, okay, and paper cups, scissor, okay, keep it with you, ready, tape also, carbon sheets, tape, paper cups, okay, this one I will show you how to do, okay, in the next class. And also one more question is there. Okay, this question. Okay, anemometer. This is called anemometer. This both we will do. Wind vane, that is wind vane. And this is anemometer. Both I will show you how to do. Okay, now coming to the third question. State two experiences that make you think that air exerts pressure. How can you say air is exerting pressure? Okay. In workbook, two examples are given, but it is not required to write only these two questions. Okay, you can write your own question. Okay, like I told you when I was teaching, when you are blowing balloon, due to air pressure, okay, the balloon will increase in size. Such kind of simple examples also you can write. Okay, when you think they are correct, then you can, okay, write in the exam. Or else, if you are having any doubt, you have to compulsorily read from the workbook. See page number from the workbook 105. Take page number 105. And see here, in the third question, state two experiments that make you think that air exerts pressure. One he has given, filling air in a football. Okay? Filling air in a football. When you fill air in a football, okay, the ball takes the shape round. Okay, air is taking the shape of the ball, and when even the player stands on it, okay, air will have energy to hold the person's weight. By this we can say air has pressure. Air is exerting pressure. Okay, very simple thing he has given, but we can take it in different ways. Okay, when you overblow the football, what happens? It bursts. It bursts. Why? It is exerting pressure. Due to high pressure, that football will get bursted up. And second one, you see, pumping the air. Pumping the air. You are pumping air in football, cycle tires and all. Okay? Vehicle tires. Okay? When you are pumping air, okay, you take the pumping machine. Okay? Try to pump it. Okay? The air moves out through a pipe. Hold the pipe without going air outside. Can you pump it? Can you pump it? No, you cannot. Okay, why? Air has some pressure. Due to that pressure, when you close that pipe other end, at the open end, when you close it, you are unable to pump it. Okay, why? Because air has pressure. Because of that, you cannot pump. And go for the fourth question. While constructing a house, where do we construct ventilators? Why? We are having ventilators, no? In your house, ventilators are there. Why ventilators are there? Because hot air present in the air, it will expand, it will rise over, it will rise up and move outside from the ventilators. Okay? To keep away or to move hot air from inside the house to outside, we are having ventilators. And other air should come inside, no? We are having windows, doors, okay? The cool air will come in and the hot air rises up, okay? And it moves out through ventilators to keep the house cool, okay? This is the reason. Now go for the fifth question. Turn your page. Okay, turn the page. See page number 106. See the fifth question. Explain why holes are made in banners and hoardings hanging in the open. When you are going out on the road, you will see the hoardings, posters, big posters will be there, no? Okay, they will be having holes in the middle. Why the holes are there? Okay, air. When air is moving, okay, if it is moving with high speed, okay, these hoardings cannot stand. It will be blown away. Okay, the posters or hoardings or the hangings will get blown away. Okay, to avoid this, what they will do? They have to make few holes in the posters or boardings or banners. Okay, mostly we will see banners outside now. Okay, when the wind is blowing speedily or little bit high in speed, okay, when they are moving through the banners, these holes will be there, no? Okay, they will get leaked. They will get leaked through these holes and the banners will not get destroyed. Okay, so they keep holes in the banners. Next question, sixth question. How will you help your neighbors in case cyclone approaches your village, town? Okay. This thing, very important question. I also explain now. We already know few things. But if you are not known others, once you have to learn them. What we have to do in the case of cyclone approaches a village? You see in your workbook. Sixth question. In case cyclone approaches our village or town, what first thing, if you are in safe condition, if you have not in a destructive, your house or your things or everything good and you are in good condition, you have to help your neighbors who are affected by the cyclone. First thing, and always listening to the news, TV, radio, okay, listening to the news. And the warnings given by the meteorological department. Okay, I said no. Who is giving the news about it? Indian Meteorological Department. You have to listen to the warnings and shift the, when already warning is given that cyclone is coming, you have to take all the essential needs, food, water, some household goods, your domestic animals along with you, and keep always with you and move from that place and shift to safer place. If you are staying already, it is already always getting affected by the cyclone, in that area you are living, like the coastal regions always they get affected by the cyclones. If you are staying in that region, you should always drink good water. Okay? In the cyclone time, okay, all everything will be contaminated. All the good drinking water also get contaminated. You have to check whether before drinking the water is safe, it is not contaminated. And you have to store the water. It is good to store good, okay, purified water before the cyclone comes. Do not touch wet switches and fallen power lines. Okay, after the cyclone, many transformers will fall, trees will fall. Okay, don't go near to that. Okay, any dangling wires are there, don't touch them. Okay, don't touch and don't go near to them. Do not go out just for sake of fun. Okay, for the sake of fun, you should not go outside and enjoy, take selfies and all. Okay. Okay, do not pressurize this rescue force by making undue demands. Okay, already the situation is bad, and don't demand for the your necessary things. Okay, don't put pressure or demand on the who is helping. Somebody will come to help. Okay, don't put pressure on them. Give some time for them, and you yourself try to manage for some time, at least for some time. Cooperate and help your neighbors and friends. Okay, cooperate with your friends and neighbors. Okay, now going for the seventh question. In the daytime, when you go out to the sea, the air blows towards us and does not go towards the sea. Explain. In the daytime, we will have which breeze? Sea breeze or land breeze? We will have sea breeze. Why? Because land gets heated up. In the daytime, land gets heated up faster than sea. So land's air will get heated up faster and it will rise up. Okay, so this space is having low pressure. Now sea air, it is cool, so that air from high pressure, it will move to the low pressure air, that is land. In the daytime, the air at the land area gets heated up faster and rises up, and it low pressure is created here from sea. Okay, the cool air with high pressure moves to the land. So in the daytime, you will have sea breezes, slightly sea breezes. Okay, now see the eighth question. He has given few statements. Okay, which of the following statements given below is correct? Okay, he has given four statements. Which statement is correct? You have to tell me. In winter, the winds flow from the land to the ocean. Okay, in winter, how is the climate? Very cool. Okay, very cool. And oceans, we have said, water gets heated up slowly, cools slowly. Land gets heated up faster and cools faster. By this, what can you say? Okay, in cool, already the climate is cool, no? We are having cool climate. Okay, oceans, okay, they get slowly cool. Who is getting faster, cooler? Land is getting cooler faster. Okay, now from here, from the land, okay, breeze, the air will move towards the sea. Keep this in the point. Next, B. In summer, the winds flow from the land towards the ocean. In summer, how is the climate? Very hot. Okay, due to hot air, air will get hotter, heated up. Will it move, rise up? Or it will move to the ocean, it will rise up, not to the ocean. C. A cyclone is formed by a very high pressure system with very high speed winds revolving around it. Okay, high pressure system with high speed winds. No, we are having low pressure in the center, high pressure around. In the center, cyclone. In the middle, you will have low pressure created. Because of that, high pressure winds will be rotating outside. This is wrong. D. The coastal line of India is not vulnerable to cyclones. Okay. In coastal places, you will not get cyclones. It seems. This means you will not get cyclones in the coastal. Coastal area means, okay, the land near to the ocean or sea. Is it correct? No, no. Okay, now you think which is correct? Among these four statements, which statement is correct? A statement is correct. In winter, the winds flow from the land to the ocean. Okay, this is the correct. Now I'll not tell you to write all the questions in your answer book, class workbook. Okay, first fill in the blanks, you write it in your textbook, don't write in the class. Okay, now I'll tell you the questions which you have to write. See the fourth question. Okay ma, fourth question and sixth question and fifth question. Okay, these three questions you write. Okay, remaining no need to write. Okay, again I will tell you, fourth question, sixth question and fourth, fifth and sixth you write. Eighth question is there, no, in the textbook itself you just put a tick mark on A. Okay, and remaining two questions are there, no, second, third. Okay, that you can later write it. Okay, I'll give you and I will tell you after that, take time and write. These three questions you have to write. That's it, your home. Okay children, thank you.